it's life has come a full circle with you launching the music of my first film, Jugni, which is a musical. So it's an honor to have you sing in the film, sing this track that we just heard, which is so beautiful. And now I speak not just for myself, because I may be the director, but it's Karan and Manas, the three of us, the co-producers of the film, who have actually made the film happen. So the director doesn't do anything, the actors don't, the crew doesn't, if the film doesn't happen. So it's really on behalf of the three of us that I welcome all of you. And I have to say that it has been such a joyous journey to work on the music of this film with Clinton. Of course, sir, it's a blessing to have one song that is sung by you. And Clinton, it has been a joyous, joyous journey. And Shelly ji, I don't see you, I don't know where you are, but it is an absolute privilege to work with people, the entire cast and crew, and musicians of this scale, level, and caliber. Nakash is here with us, Bianca is here with us, these are singers, Javed Saab couldn't make it, Vishal ji, of course. Rekha ji has sung a track, Rahat Saab has sung a track, he's not here. But I'm absolutely, absolutely in awe of the people that I'm working with. Thank you so much for giving me this privilege.
That was lovely. And I don't think there's anything that I can tell you guys about Mr. Ayyar Rahman and Mr. Vishal Bharadwaj, because it's all there and it's such prolific careers. But I think the one thing... Shivali, would you like? Mr. Rahman, it's a huge honor and a huge privilege, and I'm sure you hear that very often, but it truly is. I wanted to ask you, what was your reaction when you heard that Mr. Bharadwaj is going to be on the same album?
I'm a big fan of his films, yeah. And as a person, an amazing person and a great artist. Yeah. And so I'm really excited to be here.
Yes, and sir, Mr. Bharadwaj.
I am a bigger fan of him.
Oh God! Yeah. I think I'm gonna have to prove it. Actually, it's sounding like a contest.
No, actually, he inspires so much with his music, yeah. So much with his music. With Rahman's music, actually, the scenario of Indian music completely changed when he came in. And I remember when the Roja was introduced first, the music of Roja. That sound completely changed the whole country's perspective towards the music. He actually brought, he got the Oscar later, but I think his sound brought us to the international standard even in the 90s, way back in the 90s.
Absolutely.
So let's talk about our composer.
Yes, absolutely. We have to now get the man of the hour up on the stage, Clinton Sarijo, for this absolutely tremendous album. Clinton, straight from the heart, how does it feel right now?
Feels unreal, actually, surreal.
Yeah.
But you know what? My memory has always failed me at the best of times, so I've come prepared.
Go for it, Clinton.
So I'm gonna do this. Forgive me. Yeah. So when Shefali, Manas, and Karan first came to meet me in 2013 about this movie, it certainly piqued my interest. And, you know, certain things, it was a film about musicians, so that's cool. It was going to have a lot of songs, I mean a lot of songs. That was cool with me. But it was set in a village called Morinda in Punjab, and the music required was largely Punjabi folk. Okay. So like the first reaction in my head, admittedly, was like, why me? You know, I could easily think of several other names that would seem like more likely candidates. But I didn't let that reaction hang around in my head very long, because I saw the opportunity that it presented, you know, and I decided to take up the challenge. And I have absolutely no idea how much fun this process was going to be. And I think one of the biggest rewards came to me when a few days ago I was at Vishalji's studio and I played him a few of the songs, and he said that the way you're composing now, I really can't believe it. And it doesn't sound like, no one will believe that you've composed these songs. And for me, That was like one of the biggest rewards that I could have received. And
I thought it was some Clinton thing, you know, or somebody like that.
Wow. So yeah, first time my hands are shaking, by the way. First and foremost, I feel incredibly grateful to Shefali, Manas and Karan for the faith they placed in me throughout this process. Shefali's clarity of thought as a director has been nothing short of amazing. And as for Karan and Manas, dream producers is the word that comes to mind. If we had more producers like them in this industry, it would honestly be a very different place. So, really. I feel lucky to have had such an incredible lyricist like Shelley, who on the project, who made my life a lot easier, you know. And also of special significance is today the fact that the two men who are sitting on this stage with me have shaped my career in more ways than I can even imagine. You know, Mr. Rehman, all those nights we spent in Chennai, all those years. And like irreplaceable. That was like school for me. And so working on all your music right from Omkara onwards has been, I cannot even describe. And I also want to mention at this stage another man sitting there, Mr. Rajat Dholakia, with whom I did many ad jingles together. And that was also like for me, like going to film school and getting paid for it. Yeah, also like Mr. Ranjit Barot. I don't know if he's here. He was supposed to be here today, but I don't think he can make it. Mr. Ranjit Barot, I owe you so much. Salim also, I worked on with so many background scores. I worked on with Salim. So I just want to also thank all the singers who have sung. Nakash Aziz is here. Mr. Vishalji, of course. Rekha Bhardwaj, who also couldn't be here, who sung an amazing song on the album. Rahat Saab, who has sung Qawwali with Jazim Sharma. Neha Kakkad, Bianca Gomes, who sung a duet with me, Bianca. And Javed Bashir, who's sung two songs as well. And Mr. Rehman for actually giving us a song on the same album. That's a really, what an honor. And to the Groove Room boys, and all my producers, Simab Sen, Sachin, Hemant, couldn't have done this without you. So thank you.
Super. It's fantastic. It's a good thing you wrote that down. That's a lot of names.
Yeah, I know. I didn't want to leave anyone out.
No, absolutely. Clinton's made this beautiful album and you heard all those names. It's unreal to think that all these artists that we've grown up on should be in one album. And to take this evening forward, we have to call upon the company that's responsible for making sure that this music reaches you. I'd like to call upon Mr. Sridhar Subramaniam, President, India, Middle East, Sony Music, please. So I would think that you have a great ear for music as well.
Actually, no.
No?
No, yeah, no, absolutely not. I think what we do is we rely on people, all the people on the stage and young upcoming producers who actually try to do exciting stuff, and we try and support that. We do a little bit. They do their job.
We are very, very thankful for that. Thank you so much. We're going to bring up the plaques to commemorate the launch of Jugni's music. I'd also... Could I also please call upon Mr. Ashim Mathur from Dolby India, marketing head, to join all of them to hear every little note. You need that sound, and that's the man responsible for it. And that's a gorgeous lineup, ladies and gentlemen. And that launches the music of our film, Jugni. In fact, in the album, did he just say, oh my God, exactly. I promise it's an easy one. Do you have a favorite in the track, in the album?
You know, I must say that I have many, but I think the one that Vishal has sung is actually my absolute favorite of the lot.
The first one. Yeah, actually, you know, sir, I cried. I was sitting on a shoot and I heard that song and I just like a really wise person telling you everything will be fine. There's that quality to the song. It's so beautiful. Also, Mr. Mathur. I'm so sorry. Mr. Mathur, what would you like to say about the sound? It's absolutely beautiful. Like I can imagine for someone like Clinton, right at the beginning, you make this beautiful album and you wanted to completely reach people as you intended it. And you've been a big part of that.
Of Well, first of all, I'd like to take this opportunity to thank the team of Jugni to go for Dolby Atmos. I'm sure it's been a great tool for the creative team to actually use the format and make the songs realistic and immersive and what we just experienced a few minutes back. So I'm sure the track looks fantastic. I mean, we have seen all the songs and in Dolby Atmos, they I'm sure look even better and sound even better. And hopefully on 22nd January when the film opens, I mean, we get more people in the Dolby Atmos screens watching this.
Absolutely, absolutely. We pray for that. We'd like to open the evening to question and answers from the press. And we'll pass some mics around.
Hello. Here. Rehman, sir.
There, sir.
So I'm sure you would be offered 100 of projects every year. Why Jugni? What made you say yes for this project?
So Shefali ji has the stories about rural stories about Sufis, about music, and she's got that sensibility when she told me a couple of stories. And then of course my production company's executive producer is Karan, so he pulled me in. And these this is a song which I was doing with my spiritual teacher. So we do a lot of songs for just personal listening. And he said, I need one of those songs. So Kashif Saab has written the lyrics and the music for this one. And so I said, okay, fine.
So you also said that you're a big fan of Mr. Vishal Bharadwaj's movie. If you had to pick any one movie of his that you've really liked and any of his tracks that you enjoyed.
I've seen Omkara properly. Usually I've been always in fast forward mode and I watch most. I don't have patience. But Omkara, I watched it fully. I really loved the art of how he's directed it, the music and all the whole. Beautiful verse. Marches is my and Marches came along back as music.
Shivaji ji on your left. Congratulations for the album launch. The both of these songs are my question to you is, being this film a musical, don't you think that there will be similarities between compared this movie will be compared to Aashiqui 2 or Abhiman? So if yes, then how would you describe the differences between all these movies?
You'll have to see the movie to see the differences, but it's in a very, very real space of, like Sugandha said, a music producer going into a village. So it's a story of two worlds, two very different worlds, which you see in a very real, gritty manner. And so the music is also, you know, the completely raw and the completely processed and the completely beautiful sounds in the middle of those two as well that you're going to see. So there are no every film is something that stands on its own legs. And I hope that this will too, and I'm pretty certain that it will actually.
Vishal sir, and Rehman sir, my question to you is, sir, this movie protagonist goes to, you know, in the interiors of India to find a true talent. So talking about both of you, that you're associated with the music industry, sir, did you ever find, what do you want to say about the hidden talent of India pertaining to the music? What do you want to say about it, sir?
Yeah, I think we have a lot of talent in the country, and now when we see in the reality shows, you know, you come across so many talented singers, and so many singers have actually come. Shreya Ghoshal is one of them. So I think we have a lot of talent, and especially talent in the, you know, the inner side of the country, interior. And let me say about something about the film, because when I met Shefali, when she came to me and Clinton introduced me to her. And when I first watched the film, it was such a beautiful experience because it's a very, very honest film. And lovely performance by Sugandha, and the music is extraordinary. And Clinton, I couldn't believe that it's done by Clinton because the compositions are so earthy. You can actually smell the soil. It's so, so rooted, the compositions.
Yeah, I think
are.
I would like to add to that. So a musician comes with his influences and then he evolves. Yeah. And you can see that in Clinton, how he's changed from his sensibilities.
Yes, yes.
Thank you so much.
Yeah, the Clinton we knew, you know, he's one of the finest musicians I have ever come across. And I have worked, actually my sound of my music changed from Omkara, and the reason is Clinton. And yeah, otherwise, you know, I was just hanging in the air. He gave me the ground. He's such a fine musician. And this time he surprised me with his compositions. I mean, that Dug Dugi Dug and that Qawwali, it's like beautiful compositions. And Shefali has come, she has struggled a lot to release this film. My congratulations, and I am feeling so happy that this film is releasing finally. And thanks to Shridhar for, you know, taking the music, and I hope you promote it well.
क्लिंटन आपसे एक सवाल है ओवियर व्हाट हैज इंस्पायर्ड यू टू डू दिस एल्बम एनी यूनिकनेस और स्पेसिफिक रीजन फॉर डूइंग दिस
वेल लाइक आई सेड आई थिंक आई टुक इट एज अ चैलेंज बिकॉज फॉर मी इट वाज कंप्लीटली आउट ऑफ माय कंफर्ट जोन आई वुड से यू नो विद आई हैड डन कोक स्टूडियो बिफोर दैट एंड विद कोक स्टूडियो आई हैड डन लॉट ऑफ यू नो आई मीन इंडियन म्यूजिक एंड स्टफ लाइक दैट बट इट वाज स्टिल a very blank canvas. This was very specific because there were scenes that I had to work with and I had to actually write music to a brief, you know, and also write in that style and make it seem authentic and make it seem like, you know, like it belonged. So for me, I think taking up the challenge was not easy for me personally, but I think I, you know, I'm very, very happy with the results. And also the singers that have contributed to the album have just made it so you know, taken it to another level, each and every song. So for me, my job was made a lot easier that way.
Rehman sir, aap se ek sawal hai. It was mentioned over here ki Sufiana Kalam likha hai, as well as the lyrics and music is given by Kashif saab. So tell us something about your track in the film.
So as I said, this was done for our own spiritual satisfaction. It's my spiritual teacher, Kashif saab. And we started recording private songs for the past 10 years in my studio. Which nobody. He wrote the lyrics for Khwaja Mari Khwaja also. So when he heard it, Karan heard it, he wanted the track. He said, I need a track on that. And so I couldn't refuse. This is probably the first time I've sung one of the tracks which I've sung for somebody else has come out.
Thank you, sir.
I wasn't the composer of Rehman's track. Mr. Rehman sang for Mr. Rehman's track was composed by Kashif Saab, but Vishalji sang on my track. And actually, this is the first time. He sung for any other composer than other than himself. So for me, it's like literally
the
like
risk was his. He was taking the risk.
No, but absolutely, it was like beyond a blessing and honor. And I mean, to have AR also, to have a song on this album that I've done is like, I mean, for me, it's special significance because both these men have influenced my career in more ways, like I said, more ways than one can imagine.
Actually, I like that whole guitar second track which played.
Yeah.
It was very hair raising.
Yeah.
Very nice. And of course, Vishalji. I haven't listened to the whole soundtrack yet. I'm going to listen to it now. But it took a long time to put it together.
And now that we are coming to asking you about picking a favorite track, I'm guessing that's a very difficult thing to do. This marks the end of the Q&A, and it's a huge, huge love and truckloads of joy that you guys were here, and thank you so much. And this has been an ultimate pleasure. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
मैडी ऑल वेल हाँ ऑल वेल मैं एक कहानी सुनाना चाहता हूं आपको आई गॉट लिटिल वरीड यार ये 12 बजे मुझे कौन सी कहानी सुनाना चाहता है तो मैंने कहा मैडी अभी तो ही सेड यार 20 मिनट्स में आई विल टेल यू द स्टोरी